Hey, welcome back to the channel. Make sure that you're liking, subscribing, commenting, so that you get more life-changing videos like this one. Okay, my pitch is done. Let's get into the information here. So if you've been following along on this series, you'll remember that I've been going really deep into one of NLP's most powerful, but also most profoundly simple techniques. And the reason I put out this video series, this playlist, where I'm going so deep into the nuances of this, is because the technique itself is that powerful, but so many people mislearn it. And when you learn these subtleties by watching videos in the series, you're gonna be able to change habits, change limiting emotions, change beliefs, and your self-image, which is the most powerful driver of the results in every area of your life, for your relationships, your finances, you name it. The way you see yourself, that's what we're learning to change in this pattern. And you could be already seeing yourself in an amazing light and use this pattern to make improvements. So as we go deeper into the swish, this particular video is about one version of the swish that we call the rubber band swish. In the previous video, in video 4, we did a swish pattern where you took your trigger image and then you put your desired image within that trigger image, and that desired image grew as the trigger image got smaller and disappeared, the desired image got big and bright. Now, the swish pattern I'm sharing with you today is similar in the sense that we're going from trigger image to desired image, only we're gonna use the submodality of distance to do this pattern effectively. So instead of having two images in the same distance from you, we're gonna use distance as a driver of emotion, meaning, and intensity. The reason for this is that typically your neurology interprets things that are closer to you as more significant. For most people, this is for the majority of people watching. So if I step up to the camera like this, right, it might mean something. Or if I move in quickly, it captures your attention. Furthermore, if I move away and I get smaller as I move away, it's not as significant to you. So we want to use this feature of the mind internally to begin to program ourselves more effectively. So in this instance, you've created your trigger image. You have your desired image. And if you haven't done that yet, go back and watch the first couple videos in this series. But we're assuming that you have your trigger image and your desired image. What you're going to do is you're going to put yourself in the trigger image, seeing what you see right before you have that limitation. And then you're going to imagine that there's a rubber band attached to the trigger image and a rubber band attached to the desired image. So you're gonna take your desired image and push it far off into the distance. And as you do this, really imagine the tension in that rubber band increasing. So that as you push it out further and further and further, when you let it go, you can imagine the two images changing places quickly. So when you do the exercise and you run the pattern, real quick, it's gonna go from trigger image, and then the trigger image is gonna go whoosh, desired image. The rubber band swish, really simple, just another iteration for you to practice. And remember, the key to doing this effectively is to make sure you do the swish in one direction. So you go from trigger image, it gets pulled out into the distance, as your desired image comes in and gets bigger and brighter and closer, you see yourself the way you wanna be, and then you break state. You do something different. You open your eyes, close your eyes, you shake your body out, take a deep breath in. That break state is really important so that you chain the neurology to go from problem to solution rather than from problem to solution to problem to solution. You wanna chain an exit out of the problem or into the desired situation. So there it is, simple as that. That's the rubber band swish. We're using distance to drive emotion, meaning, and intensity. Try it out for yourself. Notice which one produces a more powerful response in your body. Do you get more of a response from having your desired image come from the distance, get bigger and brighter and closer to you until you feel incredible? Or did having the trigger image and desired image in the same distance, whoosh, and swishing them like that, was that more effective for you? And as you go through the series and try the different variations, you will learn how to calibrate to yourself to produce your own change work in the way that's most effective for you.